Scoreboard. We begin with men's soccer and head coach Matthew Brown, who hadn't been in action since October the 13th after a heartbreaking 2-1 loss at Mars Hill. Last Monday, the Bears were on the road at Mid-Atlantic Christian University, and the Bears took out their frustrations on the Mustangs. Shaw scored a whopping 10 first-half goals and added 5 more in the second half en route to a 15-1 victory. Senior forward Tilo Wilke scored a ridiculous 8 goals for the Bears in the win. Now, last Wednesday, the Bears were also on the road in Hickory, North Carolina, to face Lenore Ryan, whose mascot, coincidentally, is also the Bears. Lenore Ryan jumped out on Shaw in the first half, leading 5-0 after the first 45 minutes. Shaw would fight back in the second half behind 2 goals from junior forward Andre Matsuda, but Shaw's comeback came up short as they fell 5-3 to Lenore Ryan. Friday's match at Wingate was canceled due to inclement weather, and the Bears men are now 5-8-1 on the season. They'll face off with Salem International today at Durham County Memorial Stadium at 1 p.m. Go to shawbears.com for more information. Moving on to women's soccer. On October the 20th, the Lady Bears were on the road in Columbia, South Carolina, facing Columbia College. Jazza Curry gave Shaw an early 1-0 lead just a minute and 33 seconds into the first half. After Columbia's Charlotte Daniels came up with the equalizer at the 9:28 mark of the first half, Shaw's Tiffy Ann Brown would knock in the game winner with about 23:16 left in the first half to give Shaw a 2-1 win. Last Wednesday, the Lady Bears squared off with Southern Wesleyan University. Jazza Curry recorded a hat trick, and Tiffy Ann Brown scored the game winner in double overtime at the 103:30 mark to give Shaw a 5-4 victory. The Wingate game was canceled due to inclement weather for Shaw University ladies. The ladies are now 10-3 on the season. Next up, they will close out their season on Halloween Day at the MAC versus Piedmont International. For more information, go to shawbears.com. Moving on to volleyball and head coach Christina Coleman, who last Tuesday had their 15-match win streak snapped on the road at Johnson C. Smith as they fell 3-2 to the Golden Bulls. So what does Christina Coleman and her squad do? Just start another win streak. Last Thursday at Claflin University, 25-21, 25-10, and 25-15. Kavisha Watley paced Shaw with 10 kills, followed by Topanga Moulton's 8 kills. Michelle Omina Gonzalez recorded 32 assists in the win. Now, last Thursday, Coach Coleman's squad was on the road at CIAA rival Winston Salem State. After splitting the first 2 sets, Shaw took the next 2 sets, 25-23 and 25-23, to win the match 3-1. Michelle Omina Gonzalez had an astounding 40 assists in the win and helped Shaw Bears improve to 19-7 overall. Next up, they are at Fayetteville State tonight, 6 p.m. ShawBears.com is where you can find more information on that match. And lastly, the cross-country men's and women's squads competed in the CIAA Championships in Salem, Virginia. The men had a strong showing, finishing 8th overall with 194 points. The Bears were led by sophomore Mike Legat, who placed 3rd overall. Freshman Tartik Kiblagat finished 4th overall, and both were named All-CIAA. The women finished 9th overall. Junior Katie Ann Wendt finished 12th overall, and she was named All-CIAA for her efforts. Congratulations to a successful cross-country season for both men's and women's. Head coach Franz Kwame Smith, we salute you. And that was your Shaw Bears Scoreboard. Let's pause for a sponsor break. This portion of the Shaw Report is brought to you by Summit Hospitality. Summit Hospitality is a proud sponsor of Shaw University Athletics. With 6 Marriott-branded hotels in the Raleigh area, Summit Hospitality can manage all of your lodging needs. Make your reservations for your family or a group by calling 919-669-0576 and let them know that Shaw University Athletics sent you. That's Summit Hospitality, 919-669-0576. Yeah, had to let that beat ride for a second, man. Let that ride, man. Let that J ride. It's this old school J. You young whippersnappers wouldn't know nothing about this. But I digress. Just gave you the Shaw Bears scoreboard, man. So let's get into this CIAA scoreboard. We're going to run down these football scores. Johnson C. Smith was victorious on their homecoming, winning 31-3 over visiting St. Augs, 332 yards, 2 touchdowns passing for cornerback Antonio Wallace for the Golden Bulls. The Bowie State Bulldogs overcame an early 14-0 deficit to beat Lincoln 35-14. Amir Hall, 306 yards passing, 4 touchdowns for the Bulldogs and the win. Virginia Union blanked Elizabeth City State on Elizabeth City State's homecoming, 53-0. Ouch. Tobias Taylor, 231 yards, 4 touchdowns for Virginia Union in the win. Chawan got a big road win at Virginia State, 45-38, 4 touchdown passes for Bryce Witt for Chawan. And lastly, Fayetteville State won their homecoming game over Livingstone, 45-7. Colin Anderson, 280 yards, 3 touchdowns. So the Fayetteville State Broncos will be taking on the Bowie State Bulldogs November the 10th in Salem, Virginia in the CIAA Championship football game. Fayetteville State won the Southern Division. Bowie State won the Northern Division. And lastly, the cross-country championships I mentioned. Virginia State won the cross-country championships on the men's side, and Fayetteville State won the cross-country championships for the women. And that was your CIAA scoreboard. Well, ladies and gents, boys and girls, we got to go ahead and get up out of here. That's the end of the Shaw Report for this week. Thank you guys for listening. Big weekend for the Shaw University Athletic Department. Congratulations again to the football team winning homecoming for the first time since 2014, 26-21 over the Winston-Salem State Rams. Spoiled the Winston-Salem State's Ram chances of competing for the Southern Division Championship. So yeah, man. Sucks to be a Winston-Salem State Ram, but I digress. Thank you for listening to the Shaw Report. I'm Damian Banks, man. We're going to keep doing this every week for you guys. Basketball season is coming up real soon, so check out for the basketball scores and what's going on with head coach Joel Hopkins on the men's side of things and head coach Jock Curtis, man. Coach Hopkins is entering his 6th season for the men's squad, and Coach Curtis is starting his 19th season for the ladies, man. The men's are going to start their season off November the 10th in the Shaw U Classic, and the women start their season off November the 9th in the Conference Challenge. Go to ShawBears.com for more information. That wraps it up for this week's edition of the Shaw Report. Remember, never take no for an answer. And if the door is locked, dig a tunnel underneath the building and sneak your way in. This has been the Shaw Report. I am Damian Banks. I got 2 words for you people. I'm gone.
A heap sees, but a few knows.
Only a few.
So many have come before, but only a few can go. We invite you to our house.
That's 109.
Just make sure you wipe your feet at the door. 109 Cushman Street, Durham, North Carolina. Make a right on Wedge, then a left on Walton, and in the middle is where you find us.
That's turn 3.
Past the Gucci's, McNair's, and the Coleman's.
You're on the Cushman Street.
Miss Elaine taking clothes off the line. It's time to fold.
Fold them clothes, boy.
Pop sitting in his folding chair. Underneath the tree, working on a lawnmower.
Hand me a flathead, boy.
Said your work just getting started, boys.
Listen up.
It's too early for an encore.
Come on.
Mama tatted on my arm, sipping on the other one. Really though, liquor still flow like I'm 21.
I'm younger than many, huh? But I got the older soul. Yeah. They say I'm hard to decipher. I'm so Morris Cole.
We just try, what a bow, but my pump is cold. I know who my daddy is. Ain't no more at Pope's show. TK happens.